Cave Audio is a brand new plugin company hailing from Canada, and they introduce themselves to the world by releasing four very analog sounding plugins. Three plugins which you can purchase and one free one. In this video, an overview of these four. Hi, I'm Marlon. As introduction, these plugins are 20% off, and if you use my special code, you will get another 10% off. Link to the plugins and the code are in the description below. So Cave introduces four new plugins, and they are the Tape Face Tape Emulation, which is based on the Scully 280B tape deck, the Filk Channel, which is a channel strip based on the BFE by Filtek 70s modules. The Lunchbox is an app simulator modeled after a Vox AC30. The free plugin is the amazing Warmy EP1A, which is a Poltec EQ emulation, but very interestingly modeled after the Warm Audio EQPWA. I think that is a first. The audio you hear right now are processed with the Cave plugins. And if I turn off the Cave plugins, with the exception of the reverb, it sounds like this. Later in this video, I will do another before and after with a loud rock track. First visual impressions will usually tell me a lot about the experience I will have with the plugin. The graphical interfaces of the Cave plugins are obviously modeled after the real hardware. Visually, it's very nice to look at, photorealistic, and it has a luxurious look. What I really like is the effort taken in the knobs. It even reflects the markings around the knob. That's some great eye for detail. The plugins are resizable as well. Nothing to complain there. Let's go over the plugins one by one. Tape Face does tape emulation, and that's it. Tape does something to your audio, which is a combination of slight EQ and saturation. You can hear that really well with Tape Face when you push the input. Transients get smeared more, and there's an increase in harmonics. The link button is nice because you don't need to worry about clipping your output volume. It can be turned off if you need that. You can select from two tape speeds, 15 inch per second and 7.5. 15 is the more cleaner one, and 7.5 works more in the low end. Here you can change the meters to show input or output, and there's a bypass. On the right side, there's an interesting bias switch, which completely changes sound. The lows to low mids get pushed and the high end is rolled off, and also the saturation changes. The low boost switch will add a shelf boost below 150 Hz. With noise, you can add in some noise. If you want this tape to run in parallel, you can dial that in easily with the dry wet mix dial. The Lunchbox Vox AC30 emulation offers the choice between three cabinets or to bypass them. The plugin has a full range of amp control. A nice drive and a stomp box section. These three stomp boxes can be turned on or off individually, and they are a drive, a delay, and a reverb. Z Besides using on guitar, I liked this amp simulation on other instruments as well to add drive and character. All plugins feature an oversampling option for the ones who need that. This channel also needs something, and that is for you to subscribe. Please do so if you haven't done so already, and hit that notification bell as well. The third plugin is the Filk channel, and that is a channel strip. There's a preamp, EQ, and compressor. The EQ and compressor can be switched in the signal chain. It's not visually represented, but you can see that here. The preamp can be driven into saturation. On this bass, it results in a sweet sounding drive. And on this snare, you can hear the snare getting more splashy and the transients get shaved off. You have this trim control on the preamp of the Filk channel, which goes from -5 to +5 dB. It mostly serves to adjust the gain going to the EQ and compressor. Let me demonstrate. With this drum loop, the gain dial is set to -5 dB and the overall output gain is set to -10 dB. And the second part has the preamp gain set to 0 and the overall gain to -15 dB. There's no audible difference like this, but there is a difference. This part has both previous settings with one of the tracks face flipped. You hear there's a difference, so the gain setting does influence the sound a bit. The EQ module offers three bands of parametric EQ with a fixed bandwidth or Q setting, and there's a high and low pass filter. The bandwidth is around 2 octaves or has a Q of 1, and extends a bit more to the higher frequencies than to the low frequencies. So it's not a surgical EQ. The compressor doesn't have attack and release settings, but has pretty fast attack and release times. You set the threshold or how hard the compressor is working with the input dial. There's also a handy dry wet control if you want to use the compressor in parallel. Use the output volume and the overall output gain to compensate for volume. This channel strip can really let your drums have a bunch of smack and aggressiveness. The fourth plugin is the free plugin, the Poltec Warm Audio Warmy EP1WA. By itself, this really could have been a paid plugin in my opinion, it's really good as well. The low end of this EQ can do the cut boost trick, which will boost and cut around the same frequency. This will result in a thick low end while at the same time cleaning it up. The cut and boost for the high shelf is controlled separately. The mix knob is, and this is a literal quote from Kaeve, a saturation knob to emulate the sounds of when we tried to blow up the tube on ours. Now on this loud rock mix, of which all stems have been mixed already, I used the Kaeve in a more subtle way as a finishing touch. This is before using the plugins. And this is after. You Kyiv has made quite the entrance with these four plugins, and they have thought of everything you want from analog sounding plugins with some handy extras added. Get the plugins with the additional discount code, the link is in the description below. And the Warm Repol Tech is free, there's no reason not to grab it.